Hi there, Steven here. Today I'm going to talk to you about the Unity First Person Interaction Toolkit. This week I created a sample project for first person adventure games such as walking simulators, horror games, puzzle games, and so forth. And here we have a grab bag of mechanics, everything from sci-fi doors with valves that control them, to lights that you toggle on and off, grabbable objects that you can inspect. You have doors that function and lock and open from both ways that are physics driven. You have teleporters and, you know, inspect notes, trampolines. Over here we have drawers that are physics based and can hold things inside and open to whatever you decide. And objects that can be pushed physics wise with the character controller. We have a Half-Life 2 style ladder with dynamic sounds for climbing. And a slide, same, as well as an elevator that you can call with, you know, different call buttons. And all of this is made to be as simple and modular and sort of just plug and play as possible. There are a few caveats for the grabbable objects. Not only do they need a rigid body and the colliders themselves, but they also need a trigger that's a little larger for the sound effects for collision. For the rest of the scripts, they're pretty straightforward. They'll tell you what they need. For instance, the door needs a hinge joint, but otherwise you can just kind of give it the open and close rotations and it'll figure out the rest. Same with the valve. It will need the script for the sci-fi door, which will in turn, let's see, the sci-fi door. It will in turn need the positions of the left door and the right door. But other than that, it's pretty explanatory. The code is super well commented. So there should be a nice example of how to set up systems like this. And going forward, makes it easy to make, you know, your own games inside of it. So I'm going to open up the demo here. So the light, we have the mugs, which as you can see, there is a depth of field effect that is dynamic whenever you inspect and sort of squint. And you can kind of lock the viewport while looking at the object. You can throw it wherever you want and it'll make collision sounds, pick it up, you can put it back and it'll snap to the original position. You can set that to be true or not. The door can open sort of dynamically where you're looking. And if you can kind of lock, so I can't go through it anymore, but I can open it again. You have your notes, so you can read and sort of it'll blur out the background. This is all using the UI canvas and a shader. So here we also have a teleport pad. So if I were to throw something, it'll sort of keep the same inertia and everything. Same with your player. So there we have that. Over here we have something a little bit more fun, a trampoline. So, and to even make it a lot more fun, I've added some stairs. Here we have a moving platform, and this moving platform works not only with the player, which is a character controller, but also any physical objects. And it can call down the elevator. There we go. We have a slide. I fell off, but there you have it. And a Half-Life 2 style ladder. So it's based off of where you're looking in terms of speed. And what else? We have drawers, and you can put physics objects inside of them. And you have more collectible examples, physics objects that if you were to kind of rub up against, react to your character controller. And finally, our valve here, which based off of where you're looking in terms of the actual cursor, it closes or opens. Similar to the games like Penumbria or Amnesia. And there you have it. Some other little details. We have depth of field that's dynamic. We have zooming in and squinting. Running. Crouching. Running up. Jumping. And I think that's about it. So thank you so much. And without further ado, let me finally close with sort of an overview of the assets included. We have a lot of sample sound effects that I've edited myself. And you're free to use those however you like. Again, these scripts, they are sort of under the Mozilla license, so they're all public domain, free to use, open source. Just one sample scene. A lot of art assets. We have some shaders here. One for the text mesh stuff to be cold and not view a little bit from behind. We have a UI blur for the tinted sort of frosted look. A triplanar shader, which we're using in a few places right here for the non-UV'd sort of design geometry if you're blocking meshing something. But it's also good for the floor tiling. We also have some double-sided transparent materials for the portal. As you can see here, we're looking inside of it. So I hope you enjoy. I hope it's useful for you. And if you want to grab it, it is on GitHub. So it is here if you want to clone the repository. Additionally, if you want to just download it, it's on itch.io. And so you can download the project zip there as well as a Unity package. Or just try it out for yourself in the demo build. And it has instructions for installing. But that's about it. And thank you so much. If you like this, you might also enjoy the O3DE First Person Interaction Toolkit, which is completely open source because it's an open source game engine that it's built on top of. And already has a few contributors. So please, by all means, if you make anything with this, send it over. I would love to see what you make. And if you want to contribute, just send some pull requests and I'll likely approve them. And yeah, have a great day.